Hello everyone. Today I am discussing this Fischer-Indol synthesis. This Fischer-Indol synthesis is the widely and the common route of synthesis of indol. It is synthesized by heating this phenylhydrazone of suitable aldehyde or ketone or ketonic acid with acid catalyst to form indol. Firstly, this hydrazone will be synthesized or prepared by using or reacting this phenylhydrazine with aldehyde or ketone to form an indol using acid catalyst. This mechanism begins with the formation of first hydrazone, and the hydrazone will be through acid catalyst. The phenylhydrazone then rearranges to enamine and gets protonated to phenyl nitrogen and in 3-3 sigma tropic rearrangement, resulting in diamine and loss of aromaticity. Additional steps includes the re-aromatization and formation of cyclic aminal and expulsion of ammonia to give the indol product. This is phenylhydrazone in presence of zinc chloride to form 2-phenylindol. I am taking this 2-phenylindol. This phenylhydrazone, as we discussed, will be synthesized by reacting this phenylhydrazine with aldehyde and ketone. The first step is nucleophilic attack on carbonyl carbon. This is phenylhydrazine. This is carbonyl carbon. That is aldehyde. That is ketone, acetophenone. Then nucleophilic attack on carbonyl carbon. Then migration of proton. Next step, migration of proton and loss of water molecule. That is dehydration to form this hydrazone as a product. This hydrazone then rearranges to enamine. This hydrazone is rearranges to enamine, that is 3-3 sigma tropic rearrangement, resulting in a diamine and the loss of aromaticity. This and aromatization with cyclization is the last step to form this. This is what migration of proton leads to removal of or expulsion of ammonia to give this indol as a byproduct, as a product. So this is regarding synthesis of indol as per Fischer. And thank you.